Welcome back. Now I'm going to begin sketching up one of the horses in my oil wash. And I rely on my maul stick to steady my hand as I work. This is a hook that was made for taking clothes off of a taller clothes rack in stores. And we bought this at the Container Store years and years ago. I think it was like 1996. But I don't know if they still carry them or not. But if you want one, go to containerstore.com and you can look and see. Now I begin with my mixture of mud, which is alizarin crimson and ultramarine blue. And I've mixed liquin into it. And I've just begun sketching my horse up on the canvas. Like I said, I had penciled it in just lightly earlier, just kind of the basic landmarks of his anatomy. Now I'm going to be doing I want to establish the lights and darks. The light's coming in from the right. This is eye. I want my sketch on the horse to be, I need the detail of the planes of his face, because this is my guide to follow as I paint. So I come back in and I start washing in the shadow areas. And a little light's going to hit his top of his cheekbone there. And I have my reference up on my laptop that I can follow. I just use, in my reference, the light is not quite as strong as what I've got here, but knowing the anatomy of the horse's head helps me establish the planes that I can get them done accurately. I started out as a medical illustrator and I went to medical school, and I've actually even done some equine anatomy illustrations. So that comes in very handy now that I can, helps me in my painting. The muscles come down on their forehead and make kind of a little V. I used toilet tissue to wipe my brush, to clean my brush, and clean that quite often. That's a little lighter on that side of his head. Now I can come back if I get places, I've gotten too light, so I can come back in and just with a clean brush wipe out those areas that maybe I don't have correct. Now I want to make this light a little bit lighter so I can just lift up that wash. I prime my canvases. They come to me primed with acrylic, but I put a second coat of white acrylic on them. It just makes the surface a little bit slicker and makes it easier for me to do my wash in. And I'll start establishing the lights and shadows on his body. His shoulder, where it comes forward, catches the light. And then the light's going to hit his hips. His head and neck make a shadow that go across his body, but then the light hits the top of his hips. This really helps me later when I'm painting, because then I want to make sure everything about his anatomy is correct in the sketch. Then I don't have any problems later. I need to plan ahead. If I plan ahead, I solve all my problems before I get to painting. This leg, back leg here is also in shadow. Comes forward. And it's going to be obscured by the water splashing up, but it's just going to be lightly in shadow. This one also, as it goes down, is going to be, water's going to pretty well cover that up. I just want to establish this, the roundness of his barrel here. And his hip as it comes around. Now we'll get his legs. This can be a little shadow under here where that leg comes forward. And his armpit, as Jack would say. Too dark. His muscles pull forward because that leg's coming forward at a really sharp angle. He's really stretched out. I throw my tissue away after just a couple of wipes. You can hold it too long, you end up getting paint all over yourself and everything else. So that's, I like to not hang on to it too very long. When I first started painting, I would hang on to it and hang on to it to conserve. I thought I was saving money, and then I ended up having to use more tissue to clean up all the paint I got everywhere, and realized that it's less expensive to just throw the tissue away after two or three wipes. You won't have to use near as much cleaning up. Now this hoof is going to be out above the water. It hasn't come down in the water yet, so there's no splash up. So we'll see this hoof entirely. Now I'm just blocking in the basic shape. I'll come back and add details later, but I just want to get the basic shape of that leg and hoof in. Now this leg back here, the shadow on the other horse behind him is going to define this shoulder. And this leg comes down, and this leg is going to be, there'll be water splashing up because this leg is already hit into the water, so there's water splashing up. Now I'll come back and add more detail, but this is our basic block in on this horse. Of the basic shape drawn in. That'll need some refinement, but the shadows coming across. And his mane is going to flow down here, up. I'm not going to really worry about his mane because I'm not going to paint his mane until I paint these trees in the background. Then I'll paint the mane then so I can pull it wet into those trees in the background. Also his tail. going to kind of swing around like that. Just get a nice flow to it. He's going to have a little more light hitting his muzzle here. See, I use different size brushes. I use the biggest brush I can until I need a smaller one. I appreciate you watching my YouTube videos. Please feel free to ask questions. You can do that in the comments section. And do subscribe. You'll receive an email every time that I post a new video on YouTube. I also have a blog. The address is in the description below. And I've put the address also on the final frame of my video. So there we go. Like I say, that'll need a little more refinement, but we basically have that horse positioned on the canvas where I want him to be. I thank you, and you have a wonderful, wonderful day.